Today is December 9, 2020. Hello, hello, hello. Solutions to problem number 100. When we assume that the gravitational potential energy at infinity is zero, it's a choice we have, but it is the only meaningful choice, then the question is, what then is the gravitational potential energy at the surface of a planet, and we'll take the Earth for numerical values. And then, which is harder, what is the gravitational potential energy at the center of that planet? Let's first agree on how we define gravitational potential energy. This is the ground, this is my house. I arbitrarily call this level here, gravitational potential energy, to be zero. That's my choice. If I want to know now what the gravitational potential energy is as this level H1 above PE equals zero, that is plus mgh1. It's positive, because the work that I have to do to move mass little m from zero potential energy to this point here is positive work. So the work that Walter Lewin has to do is plus mgh1. Now I go from here to this level, h2, below the potential energy of zero. Now the work that Walter Lewin has to do is negative work. And therefore the gravitational potential energy at this level is minus mgh2. High school physics. Now, when you go very large distances relative to a planet, the Earth, then the gravitational force becomes an important dependence of the distance. So you can no longer assume that over this distance h, this g, the gravitational acceleration of 9.81 meters per second square, will not change. It will change. So now we choose our zero potential energy somewhere else. I discussed that thoroughly in one of my lectures. You have choices, but the only meaningful choice really is to call it zero at infinity. So now comes the question, what is the potential energy at position r, radius r, away from the planet, which is very far to the left? So that's the work that Walter Lewin has to do to move the mass little m all the way from infinity to this point r. It's obvious that the answer must be negative. Look at this. It must be negative. I must be doing negative work in going from infinity to r. Since many of you have difficulties with plus and minus signs when it comes to the direction of dr and when it comes to the direction of Walter Lewin's force, I make a proposal. Let's calculate the work that Walter Lewin has to do to move the mass little m from location r to infinity. You will have no problems doing that. Obviously, that's going to be positive work. And you will have no sign problems. So clearly, if you find the answer, then you know what the gravitational potential energy is at this point. You just flip the plus sign to a minus sign. Ready? So, we now go from here to infinity. So when we go from here to infinity, the work done by Walter Lewin is the integral of r to infinity of mmg over r square, which is Walter Lewin's force to overcome the force of gravity, dr. That's a trivial integral. It is minus mmg over r between r and infinity. We know it is zero at infinity, so it is a positive value. Of course it is a positive value, because when I go from here to infinity, I have to do positive work. Therefore, the gravitational potential energy at this point is the negative of this value, minus mmg over r Earth. And if you put in the numbers there, little m is 1 kilogram, the mass of the Earth is approximately 6 times 10 to the 24th kilogram. Capital G is 1.6 times 10 to the minus 11. And the Earth's radius is about 6,400 kilometers. All of that you have to bring back to MKS, of course. So you find then that it is about minus 6.3 times 10 to the 7 joules. Of course minus, because if it is zero at infinity, all values from infinity to the Earth all have to be negative. So that was not so difficult. Now comes the hardest part. We now go to the center of the planet, where the gravitational force is obviously zero. But that doesn't mean that the gravitational potential is zero, because the gravitational potential is energy. Energy is very different from force. The two are as different as elephants are from coconuts. For me to go from infinity with mass little m all the way to the center of the Earth, you better believe it, I have to do work. Be it negative, but nevertheless, I have to do that work. So what counts is not that the gravitational force is zero at the center. What counts is how much work I have to do to get there from infinity. All right. So now I'm going to make another proposal to simplify matters, to avoid that you're going to run into problems of minus signs. Instead, we already have calculated the work I have to do to go to the radius of the Earth. This is the radius of the Earth. But now we have to go inside the Earth. I'm now going to calculate not the work I have to do to go from the surface of the Earth to radius r, but I'm going to do the reverse. How much work do I have to do to move mass little m from radius r to the radius of the Earth? That will definitely be positive. I have to do positive work. I flip that number, and then I know the difference between the gravitational potential energy here and there. And then we're almost finished. So, Walter Lewin taking mass little m going from r to r plus dr. This is the amount of work that Walter Lewin has to do. Capital M with this little r now means the mass which is inside this sphere, the mass outside that sphere has no effect. It's all that matters is the mass inside that radius r. If the density is constant, that's why I put this here on the side, to a reminder, if the density of the matter is constant, is the same everywhere, and we really have to assume that, otherwise it becomes a nightmare, then the mass inside this radius small r is a fraction of the total mass of the Earth, and the fraction is r cubed divided by r of the Earth cube. That's rather trivial. So therefore the work that Walter Lubin does in going now from the center of the Earth to the radius of the Earth is this integral going from zero to the radius of the Earth. I now have the r cube here, and I now have the r square here, which is this r square. And that turns out to be 1/2 mmg over r Earth, a trivial integral. Well, we already know that at the surface, the potential energy is minus mmg over r Earth. So we have to add now minus 1/2 mmg over r Earth to find what it is here. So the potential energy at the center of the Earth, center of any planet, is 1.5 times the gravitational potential energy at the surface. Not at all obvious, is it? The minus sign we have already explained, I'm not going to go over that. And so, using then the numbers for the Earth, we will find minus 9.42 × 10⁷ joules. About 50%, maybe 40% of my viewers have the answers correct in terms of the value, but they have the signs wrong. Most of them do not recognize that if the gravitational potential energy at infinity is zero, that the gravitational potential energy at any distance from the Earth, including the surface, including the center of the Earth, must be negative. Yeah, about 1/2 of you have the misconception that if there is no gravitational force at the center of the Earth, then the gravitational potential energy is zero. One student told me that that's even what her physics teacher taught in class. Holy Michael, holy Michael, holy Michael. As a reminder, for those of you who have taken my 802 course, Electricity and Magnetism, you can have a point P in space where the electric field is zero. Therefore, if you put a charge there, Q, the force on that charge is zero. That does not mean that the electric potential at that point must be zero, because that depends on charges in the vicinity of that point. Very similar to here. Forces and energies differ as much as elephants differ from coconuts. Have a nice day. Take care. We're now past problem number 100. And we will march on in 2021. Get your COVID-19 vaccination. Get it as soon as possible. I am very high risk. I'm 84 years old. I'll make every effort to get it perhaps as early as February 2021. Preferably before my birthday, which is January 29. All right? So, we agree, we will be friends. That's a given, and that will never change.